this is a video that I don't think anybody else has made a video like this. And you certainly don't read about this crap in photography magazines. Ultimate value. I mentioned before about this lens is a new Nikon 7200 2.8. This is just one example. Value. If you are, let's say, a club, okay, obviously the shot pays. Like if you're a paparazzi, if you get the shot, then you're the guy that's making the money. If the other people can't get the shot, they're screwed, and you're the guy that comes home with a paycheck. If you have a bunch of other photographers working against you, and you nail the shot and they don't, then you got a leg up on them. Obviously, you have to have the damn skills. We're not talking about damn skills here. The skills are a necessity. But if you take the best race car driver in the world and stick him in an old beat-up pickup truck, he isn't going to do jack shit on the racetrack, is he? Has the best skills in the world, he also has to have the equipment. Like the Nikon D500, the insane... I've uploaded... some 40,000 IS. I basically can't even see what the hell it is I'm shooting at. But even straight out of camera, the pictures are way decent enough for 8x10. You apply some noise reduction software, the D500 high ISO is absolutely the tits. It's incredible. You combine that with the 70-200. This setup, by the way, is basically $5,000. Lens and camera and vertical grip. We're looking at $5,000 right here. More so than any other camera out there, I don't care if it's a Sony or a Canon or a Fuji, you go into a dark club and you're shooting a singer or it's a, some sort of a street shoot late at night, say a carnival's going on, you will own everybody else's damn ass. The question then becomes, like the 70-200 2.8 Tamron, which I've recommended endlessly, great lens, $1,500 new, basically $1,000 used. This is basically twice that much new, $2,800 for this lens. If you're a working professional, not only is this damn lens a tax write-off, but it gives you that extra, I don't know if it's 5% or 6%, I'm actually thinking between this and the Tamron, an additional 8%. That combined with like the Nikon D500 with this insane, absolutely batshit crazy, insane, high ISO performance. I'm taking shots that are basically pitch dark at 40,000 ISO straight out of camera are incredible. Not talking about this lens specifically, but talking about the camera. The question then becomes value. If you're amongst a bunch of other... I was on vacation as a perfect example, and we were all pointing cameras at an Osprey, and you had all these knuckleheads with point-and-shoots, and you have some people with some 70-200s, and you know they basically couldn't see shit. I mean, I was sitting there hand-holding with an Nikon D500 and the 200-500 Nikkor, hand-holding, incredible vibration control, reaching at 500 millimeters. I uploaded the picture like about a week or so ago. You can see the fish in the Osprey's claws. I mean, I know amongst that whole group of people there, that was the only, and I was not in a group, by the way. I hate going in groups. I don't believe in like group photography, really. But among that group of people, they're all pointing their damn cameras and this. I know I was the only person that got that shot. I know I was. I mean, there's just no question about it. Period. Period. Just no question. What does that extra 5 or 10% actually mean as far as it's worth to you? Perfect analogy, as I've mentioned before, people talk about these race car drivers. They'll have like a $100,000 engine, not in the car, not the car prize, but the damn engine alone. And they're like blowing up or destroying those suckers like every 2 weeks or every month. It's like, you know, holy shit, you know, that engine costs 5 times more than my car, and it is only lasting you, you know, a month, maybe 2 weeks. I mean, sometimes during a heavy race, like some of those, and I don't watch race car crap at all. This is just a perfect example. You know, sometimes they'll actually blow up 2 engines in a day. It's like, well, shit, there went $200,000. And, you know, to the professional race car driver who's being sponsored, who's actually, you know, doing this professionally, you know, his answer to that is, you know, who gives a shit? And it's the same as the case of the photographer. Obviously, they're not making the heavy money like the race car driver with tons of sponsors. But if it gets you that extra 5 or 10%, gets you the shot, and this lens, for example, and this camera, you know, is considerably more expensive than, you know, your dinky camera and, you know, your typical 70-200 2.8, well, you're the only person that got the damn shot. Well, you got a huge... You obviously have to have the damn skills. We're not talking about the damn skills. The damn skills are obvious, okay? We're not talking about that. We're talking about the ability of the skills combined with the gear to be able to reach that point that no other people can reach. You know, if you're in a really dark ass dank club and some famous singer is up on stage and everybody else is struggling to stay in focus and their high ISO shots look like dog shit even after noise reduction software is applied, and you're sitting there, you know, at 20,000 or 40,000 ISO, and this camera, by the way, takes really incredible pictures at 40,000 ISO, as I've proven time and again. I mean, if you're nailing it and nobody else is, what advantage does that give you? You know, what is the actual value of that expensive camera and of that lens? Can you justify it? Are you the working pro that actually knows that if you get the shot, that counts for everything? I mean, you could drive 1,000 miles, as many photographers do, to shoot a special event. And you think, well, I haven't got the skills. And maybe you do, or that person does have the skills. But if the gear doesn't perform, then, you know, okay, you know, so you're a tightwad. You know, you're getting paid. You just drove 1,000 miles to do a gig. You really didn't get the shots like you'd wanted to. I mean, if you'd actually got the gear that gives you that extra 5, 6, 10%. Usually it's about 5 to 8%. Like this lens is the extra 6 or 7 or 8% over every other 70 to 200. Then you've got a leg up. That means your skills combined with this, you know, then you've got it. This camera with this lens, for example, there's no, I don't, nothing from Canon and nothing from Sony will own it like this, like in a dark, dank ass, you know, I don't care if it's outdoors or indoors, some sort of event. Or gig, some sort of shooting gig, or you gotta handhold your crap. You know, it's just a monopod is out of the question. You gotta crank up the ISO to 25,000, you know, get some great VR shots, and you know, the ISO noise has to look good. You're obviously gonna run into some signal processing, but you've got the shots. This is that, and this equipment pays for itself if you're the working guy, the working professional, he or she. There's the real value. You have to be able to justify it, but if it's justified and you're the person, you know, that's showing up to this, you can't drive 1,000 miles to, you know, a famous fishing hole and, you know, show up with a stick with a string on the end of it. You know, it's like, what the hell did you even show up for? You know, if that's your gig and that's what you're being paid to do, then show up with the right equipment to do it. That all this bullshit talk, people flapping their lips. I've heard so much crap. Like for example, on this lens, oh God, that lens is $2,800. This lens is worth every damn bit of $2,800. This lens is the shit. I mean, nothing else comes close to it. It is worth that for the guy that shows up. Someone makes a phone call and says, you know, fly out to LA. We got a gig. We want you to shoot. We love your shooting skills. You know, this lens has already paid for itself before he's even jumped on the plane. His skills or her skills combined with that gear, that's it. So, this whole talk about expensive lenses, you know, I'm all about value. I'm all the time talking about the best value. But, I mean, if it's the best shit, it's the best shit. Excuse my language. You know, price be damned. I mean, I know price is important. It's like, well, you know, you'd say, well, I'm not the working pro. You know, I just do this for fun. I do it. That's fine. That's understandable. I'm not stupid. I understand that, damn it. The point is, you know, if someone says, what's the best? You know, it's not often people say, you know, cost be damned. But I actually hear that quite often. It's like, cost be damned. What's the best shit? You know, boom. Don't care what it costs. What is it? You know, that information is important. You know, a lot of people don't have that issue, and it's obviously a good issue to have. But you know, here's one example. So we're talking about justifying it, the value, and you know, if it's justified and you're the working guy or girl, then you know, it's like the guy that blows up a $100,000 car engine every 2. You know, he's like, well, that engine alone's $100,000. You blow him up like every 2 is. So who gives a shit? So, you know, I need it. I have to have it. I need it. It costs what it costs, what it costs. You know, deal with it. And that's the same when it comes to stuff like this. So I think all the talk about this lens being overpriced is bullshit. It depends on who the hell you're talking to. This lens is not overpriced, depending on who you're talking to. Thanks for watching. Catch you later. Bye.